Okay, so to finish out this example, we've got this dilemma where if we come in and we run our game and we say heads, it was tails, you lose. And I didn't even try, by the way. Whoops. I didn't even try entering a zero or something. Invalid input, try again. Five, invalid input, try again. Okay, so let's enter heads. One, it was tails, you lose. Man, I am having some great luck at this. Play again, yes. Enter one for heads. It was tails, I lose again. Enter one for heads. It was heads, I win. Okay, so I finally won, so I'm going to say no. And it says I won one out of three games. That's 0%. Well, the problem here is that we have number of wins, which is always going to be smaller than the number of flips, or at the very least, it could be equal to, or at the most, it could be equal to. So that would be 100%. And if it was 100%, by the way, I think it would print just fine. The problem is we've got some integer division here, right? We're taking an integer and dividing it by an integer, and that is the result. And so what we're saying here, in this case, I won one out of three games. We're saying how many times does three go into one? Well, the answer is zero, and so that's why it prints out a zero. In order for this to print out correctly, one of these two numbers has to be a double at least, and maybe both of them. Well, so how do we fix that? Well, I'm going to take this print line down to the next line, and then we talked about the fact that we can fix that by casting one of these numbers to be a double, and we could cast both of them, but if at least one of them is a double, so if I put a double in here, that will cast number of wins from an integer to a double, and that should fix our dilemma here. And so now I say one for heads. Man, tails is lucky. Play again. Okay, I won there. I'll play three games. Okay, so I got one out of three again, and if I say no now, then that says that's, well, it's 0.33, and if we're going to make it a percentage, I guess technically what we should do is take this result, so take this whole thing, put it in parentheses, and then multiply it by 100 after we're done in order to get the result. Okay, so do you understand what we're doing? We had to cast this to get that percentage. I could have casted this one just as easily, but one of the two has to be a double in order for it to come out as a double. And then after I get the percentage, then I'll multiply it by 100, so I actually get it in a percentage format instead of a decimal format. So let me try it again. So I'm going to go with tails all this time. It was heads, you lose, play again. X, it's invalid input, try again. Yes, play again. I lost again. Now I'm getting all heads. Play again. Yes, two for tails. It was tails, I won. So this time I won, well, I guess still one out of three. Play again. No. And then I get in this nice format 33.33%. Now we haven't talked about formatting these numbers to look pretty, but we'll talk about that in a future lecture. Let me try and win more than one out of three games. So I'm going to do heads, I lost. Heads, I win. Heads, I won again. Okay, so now I've got at least two wins. And now if I say no, then that tells me 66% of the time I won. Okay, and let me do like five games. So one, play again, yes, one, 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 and was that five? Play again, no, yeah, so I won three out of five games. That's 60%. Not bad, right? And that's a program. Now, I was just thinking about this because my wife and I are in the process of building a house, and the house, it's amazing because it starts by, digging this hole, and then they pour the footings, and actually they, well, yeah, they set some forms and then pour the footings, and then they set more forms and pour the foundation, and it's this process that happens to where it creates this house that's so complicated in the end. All these different parts to the house to make the house what it is. But each individual thing, take this 2x4 and put a nail in it. That's a really simple thing. And so we look at the program we've created. If we go here in the view and look at line numbers, this is a nearly 100-line program. Yet each individual part in and of itself is pretty simple. Okay, it's things that we've done or looked at in the videos leading up to this example. We come in, we import the scanner and the random, which we've done in different videos, the scanner to read an input, the random to get different numbers, and we build an instance of each to use. I called this one N, I called this one R. Then I set up a number of variables that I'm going to use. User pick, flip result, number of flips, and number of wins that are all integers. And then string for play again to hold the text. Then I come into this game and I'm going to do this game while, down here at the bottom, the user said to play again. As long as they selected yes, then we're going to play again. Okay, so I come into this loop. I ask the user, do you want it heads or tails? One for heads, two for tails. And then I check to make sure that they have valid input there. I say while what they entered was not a one and it wasn't a two, then we're going to print out invalid input. We're going to ask them again to enter one for heads or two for tails and then get their input again. And we'll keep doing that over and over again while their pick was not a 1 and it wasn't a 2. Okay, once we get out of this loop, that means we have valid input. So now I'm going to simulate the coin flip and increase the count of games. So I set my flip result equal to a new random number. I'm going to go get a random number, the next int, out of 2. And that's going to give me a 0 or 1. I'm going to add 1 to it to give me a 1 or a 2. And then I'm going to increase the number of flips count so I know how many games that I've played. Then I check. Oh, I never put a little comment in here. That's not good. So I need to... I did put it. I just put it down here. Wait, what did I do? Oh, this goes with the... That's right. So that tells me that wasn't very clear. Print which side was flipped. And that will now be a little note to tell me which side was flipped. And then I check and print the result. So here I say if the flip result was a 1, then we're going to print out it was heads. If the flip result was a 2, we're going to print out tails. And then we check and print the results. If the user pick is equal to the flip result, we're going to tell them they won, and we're going to increase the number of wins variable to say we won one more game. Otherwise, they lost. If it wasn't equal, then they lost. Then we need to flush the buffer because we've gone from reading a number in to where we're going to read some text in. And I ask them, do you want to play again? Yes or no. Read in their input, and then again we do a check to say while... I'll make this so it doesn't run off the screen. So while they didn't choose a Y and they didn't choose an N, then we need to tell them it was invalid input, try again, and then read in the line again. And we're going to keep doing this as long as there wasn't valid input. And then this while belongs to the do while loop to say, are we going to play the game again? And then after we get done playing the game, so after we get outside this while loop is when we then print out the results. You won, and we concatenate on the number of wins, 2 out of, and then concatenate on the number of flips, games, and then we're going to print the results. That's, and then we go in and do the calculation. We cast this to be a double so that we don't get integer division, and then multiply that by 100 to make it a percentage, and then print out the percentage and exclamation point so it looks nice and fancy for that printout. All right, so that's this program. Again, taken as a whole, it might be pretty intimidating at this point, but each individual part is just something you know already based on assuming you've watched the videos up to this point. Just a couple of common errors. If I accidentally flip a wrong brace and I make both of those opening braces, I'm going to get an error that says reached end of file while parsing. That means it ran out of code before it thought it was supposed to. And that means that you're missing a closing brace somewhere. Whenever you see this message, you're missing a closing brace somewhere. So I got to come back in and find where I changed it. I got to be more careful about what I change. If by chance I missed an opening brace, then that was a nice handy error. It told me opening brace expected. It probably matters where it is. Let me try just taking this one out and see. So it says while expected on this brace, which is kind of a strange error, but that's because it comes as a set, right? If we miss a semicolon, generally it will just tell us missed a semicolon. If we missed a parentheses, a lot of times it's the same thing. If we accidentally typed in next int with a lowercase I instead of with an uppercase I, it's going to tell us something like cannot find symbol. I don't recognize, and it points to it. After this dot, I don't recognize anything that comes after that. And you say, well, next int, that's just a method. Well, because Java's case sensitive, it knows what next int with a capital I is, but it has no idea what next int with a lowercase I is. And a lot of times we'll accidentally spell our variables wrong. Same thing, user pick. If I do it with a lowercase p, cannot find symbol, user pick. Well, that's because most of the time a cannot find symbol is a miscase or a misspelling, at least in my experience. And so now the program will run fine because now it matches up with the way I declared it up at the beginning. And so those are just some common errors that you might run into. Sometimes we get where we only get one equal sign. Well, incompatible types. I can't flip result. Well, the problem here is that's kind of a misleading error because flip result is an integer and I'm trying to set it to an integer, but it's done inside the if statement, which I can't do. And so I need to have the double equal sign. And so there's a lot of those little syntax errors that can occur in the program. If I have one plus instead of two pluses, it's going to give me an error. A legal start of expression. Some of these errors are not very, the messages aren't very helpful, but that's because I need to have two pluses there. If I accidentally get some code in between here, system.out.println hi, I'm going to get an error, else without an if. Well, wait a second, how does that work? Well, that's because they're not tied together anymore. I've put something in between them. Sometimes we'll get an error like this. Else, user pick equals 5 or something, and we get an error. That's not a statement. The problem is I can't have a condition if I'm doing an else. I either have to do an else if and then have the condition, or just make it an else, which is all-encompassing anything else. All right, well, there's probably other errors that will pop up, but that's some of the ones I can think of, and hopefully that's helpful to kind of go through this program together, start to finish, implement the things that we've learned, and then look at some common errors. And so that's it. It's just one piece at a time, and all of a sudden we build a program that's tens of thousands of lines of code, but each individual line, generally speaking, most of them are pretty simple. All right. Very good. Spencer out.